நாளை சுற்றுவோம் இமை சுட்டரிக்க புதியதோர்
One of our acharya has been butchered, all of you know. A child has been kidnapped, a child has been raped, gang raped, a child has been butchered. A child has not been allowed to be buried in her native place just because that child who does not know who she was, who she is, what religion means for her, so just punish it for that. Shocking, devastating. But more shocking is the silence of those in authority. The shocking incident took place in the month of January. And our Prime Minister opens up the mouth in April. No word. No time to express concern about that. That poor child. Is this India of my dreams, your dreams? Is this the future of my children? Who is that child? Whose child he is, she is? I was just reminding you, my young stars, own the pain of the young stars in Kashmir. I appeal to the people of the country, share the pain, share the pain of this child. Are you sitting looking through the prism of religion? What this, what the religion she was, what caste she belonged to? Are these the questions to be asked about such a brutal act? Can you imagine in today's world, in a particular area, the political representatives, those in authority in those areas in the government, they are reluctant to share the grief of that family. They are reluctant to visit those unfortunate parents of that child. Can you imagine? Just for what? Who is promoting the space for violence? Who is promoting that animation? These are the questions which are involved. It is not an isolated incident. It is an unfortunate, extremely shocking. It has shaken us. But where's the background? Those Gujars and Bakarwals, they belong to one community. They are settled here in Kathua area. just to evict them from their land and property. This most condemnable act was organized and initiated.
Even though I wonder, it's not the question of what certain restitutors, certain bad elements in that particular area did. More shocking is, those leaders were at the helm of affairs, ministers in the government. They are trying to obstruct the process of investigation. Not ordinary people. They are organizing under the banner of Hindu Ekta Manch, using religion as a tool. Not to side with the victim. Not to seek justice for the victim. But to provide excuses for protecting the accused. And they're not the same people who are part of the government here. They're not trusting the very instruments which are working under their guidance, Jammu Kashmir police, who are being hailed, praised for their courageous struggle against violence, militancy. They are not being tested for an investigation now. Now the demand is CBI must come forward, not Jammu and Kashmir police. How unfortunate. A few persons from the bar, they are obstructing, who are part of the justice system. They are preventing police from filing the charge sheet in the court. And Supreme Court directs Bar Council of India to constitute a committee and investigate. And Bar Council of India, that committee is not asking anything, they are asking a CBI probe, which was not, they were not asked to suggest which agency should probe and which agency should not probe. My simple question is, on whose side you stand by? For the victim or for those who are alleged to be involved in that heinous crime. If you ask me, the source of today's crisis in Kashmir is mistrust, distrust, and the challenging task before the nation, before the country is how best we can take confidence building measures, corrective measures, take initiatives which can help us in relation to the people of Kashmir. That is the only path which can lead us to some better alternatives, better solutions for overcoming the crisis. But on the other hand, such like the Kathua incident being used as a tool for political divide, using as a tool for political polarization is, to say the least, shameful. It is shameful. It is, I think, I have no words to express my concern about whatever is happening regarding this incident. The same community of people, Gujar and Bakarwal, known for their patriotism, known for their sanity, what kind of message is going there? What kind of trust you are bringing within their ranks? That's why I am here today this evening to appeal, because I have no hope about the present dispensation, the present leadership of the country. They want votes, they want elections, they want division, they want polarization, they want destroy whatever sanity is left now. Stand up, my brothers and sisters, wherever you are. Save Kashmir, save India. Save the future of this great country that can be, that we shall do that by uniting together, resisting the onslaught of these disastrous policies pursued by BJP-led government as of now. But I must leave now with a message that for the people of Kashmir, that we are not alone. You have friends and supporters elsewhere. Maybe those in authority have done many wrongs, but there are people of India who still have concern about the future of the people of Kashmir. And I assure you, for the people of Kashmir, the rest of the country, that we still have, we will continue to have hope about a better future together. We will fight together, we will shape our future together. My only appeal this evening is, whatever our political, ideological differences, whatever our caste and creed, my only appeal is that today is the time that we should stand up and say that no more hate, no more politics of hate that divide is required for this great country. Stop it and stop it now.